Hello, this is Elizabeth Craft Designs. A bit late because somehow I cannot always find what I'm looking for. So let me see if this works. If I see people coming in, let me see. Yeah, it works. I don't know why. Oh, okay. Here we are. Happy Friday. Happy Friday. So I'm just going to wait till some people are coming in and I get that star thing again. Don't do that. Hi Petra, Belinda, and Ans, Linda. Hi everybody. So yeah, I don't know. Sometimes I just don't know. I don't see the screen. So I was panicking already. Calling Mark, couldn't hear him. Calling, oh, that's my notes. I see my notes are in the screen, so I'll remove those. Yeah, happy Friday. So trying to call Mark, trying to call Anna. I said, oh, it doesn't work again. Really, sometimes you see my handwriting, that is really bad. Happy Friday, I know, it is happy Friday. And I was having so much fun already. And I thought, oh, why are things going wrong now? Just can't handle that. Hi, Anita. And so on my notes, I had written down, I know, it was stressful. So, of course, a like and comment. And if you want to share, please do so. And it's going to be a fun one. I have some fun stuff to show, I'm pretty sure. I had fun already. And it's quiet here in the apartment because the kids are... even see the tape here. Wait, I'm going to move you a little bit this way. So, sorry. Because you even saw the tape here on my table. Hi Jackie. So kids are going on the mountain. Annika had half a day, so he's actually off right now. And Tom was free already, and now it's not straight. So I need to do one small correction, sorry. Because you know I can do the crooked. I always say I can do crooked. And I want to try to get it. Well, that's okay. And so it's quiet in the apartment, which has not been the case all the time with the kids around. So it's peaceful here. So without the stress, look at that. Without stress from the start, it's actually really nice. Okay, hi, Ase, I probably totally pronounce it. From Norway, hi Rick and Rhonda and Maureen. From Hawaii, Maureen, that is nice, never been there. And Debbie, hi Debbie, nice to see you here. And T, happy International Coffee. Oh, is it International Coffee Day? Oh, then I should have done something with the pumpkin spice latte. But it's also, I can still do that later. It's also a World Card Making Day tomorrow. So tomorrow is World Card Making Day and it is, so we do a special. So I don't know if Anita got the newsletter, but we're actually doing 20% off of the collection from Anita. It started today using the code CARDS. And it's, so code CARDS. And you get 20% off the full collection from Anita. And it ends Sunday night. And then the spotlight of the week is the 2021 full Halloween release from the Planner Essentials and from Josette. If you subscribe to our YouTube channel and comment, on the release video for a chance to win a $100 gift certificate to our online store. It ends the 5th and we will announce the winner on the 6th. It's in the description box under the video, but also we will announce it on Wednesday during our live. It is National Coffee Day. Okay, I should have done that. Okay, so you might have seen something already, so I'm going to work on this one. And then I'm going to combine it with something from Josette, with something from the planner, or journal, sorry. And I have something from the mason jar here. So I'm going to work in my fall journal. Reason for that is that the leaves are really falling here now. It's going fast because I told Joep and Mark and my mother-in-law to take a little baggie and collect some leaves for me, more leaves. And then Mark sent me a picture like with Tom with like a million leaves. So I said, do you have a bag with you?
I know, that's ridiculous. That includes the pizza box. Yes, that is correct. The 20% discount includes the pizza box. That's probably, did I say Angelique saying that? Yes, Angelique. I was going to mention that, but yeah. So what I did this morning already, I made this page for my, and I will do this in a later life because this really was an experiment and I actually did some things wrong. So what you start with, you start with a piece of tape on cardstock. Piece of tape on cardstock, and you see I did the 6-inch tape here because now that I did this, I want to make a larger one. And then I took off the release sheet. Now let me see the comments. Yeah. Took off the release sheet, stuck down some leaves, and you see I had some nice colors, and it might completely change because these are not completely dried yet, but we do have maple leaves here. So because it's maple leaves, you know, Canadian, that's the maple leaf, of course, the official kind of sign. And so once I have maple leaves on there, so I have those, and then I just find some other leaves. I stuck them to the tape and then added some glitter. And in this case, I used the saffron glitter. And I used, I know, pizza box for everyone, yeah. And the distress powder here, and that is the spiced marmalade that I used. So that is what I did for the background. And then I thought, oh, then I have a great background to work on in my fall journal. So I had this page in here already. Oh, and two updates, or not updates, of course. Don't know anything about the paper in the US yet. Watercolors from the Netherlands. The promise was the 5th of October, but of course that changed. I think the boat is in the harbor now. Oh, that might be the 5th. Unloading the 8th, because that takes a few days. And then delivering the 11th. So I definitely, I'm not going to bet any money on that. Because things change. But that is the schedule now. So still patient. This is just a tape, so what you do, and I will show that because if the kids bring nice leaves, otherwise I can find them myself during the weekend. But so you take off the release sheet and that's all sticky. And then, see, so this is all sticky. And then I just put the tape on the leaves on there first. And then what I actually did, so I did stick the leaves down and then pieces break off. Oh, I still have a loose piece here, I see, and I can leave that. But I can also take a brush, you see, and kind of brush it off where it overlaps. But, you know, it's also fine if you leave it. But you can brush it off. But so stuck the leaves to there. Then I run it through my die cutting machine, putting that release sheet on there again. So because otherwise, of course, it sticks because I did not have glitter and tape on there yet. Yeah, I will do, Debbie. I will do this on Monday. And then I added the glitter and it's actually super simple, but as you, I don't know if you can see that, but I did do a wrong thing here because I added, instead of, because I use sheets for this one. So instead of using the smooth side of the, kind of the release sheet to press it down, I use the paper side. So it's stuck to there, you see. So this is actually paper from the release sheet, the wrong way around, which is actually nice in this case. So I did that wrong. And then you also know that I did something wrong with my glitter, because normally you brush off your glitter in your coffee filter, and I did it on my Swiffer, but I put that back in the coffee filter, and then so you lose a little bit in your Swiffer, but that's fine. But and you take a new Swiffer, but at the end it turned out really cool. I will lift it up. Well, you saw the picture already. It actually looks pretty cool. So you can imagine already. So what I want to do, I want to add some spruce tree on this as well. So this is watercolor paper, and the spruce tree are from the mason jar. You see, those are these from the mason jar, and I have that one here. You see, so I want to use that. And I'm doubting if I am going to color that in green or more in kind of an ochre yellowish color. Because here we have the trees coloring, you have the spruce trees, but then you also have the larch. And the large trees are turning really like golden yellow. So I might do that. And then I cut some of the mushrooms. And I cut some of the pumpkins from the collection from Josette's. And then I wanted to include, but I don't know if that's it. So that's my, by the way, that's my fern leaf pizza box. So, and you see there's a maple leaf. That probably goes on there. So going to do something with the ferns as well. So one page is going to be like a scenery, more fall. And then on the other one, I want to do something with the ferns as well. So that's my fern and maple leaf pizza box. Then I also have my Into the Woods pizza box, of course. I also have my winter greens pizza box. And you see that one? So that's in here because that is actually a nice color on there. And what I figured out, but this is already glued down, my transparency had plastic on it. The same as with my boxes. And what else do I have here? Well, I do have, I did bring this box out as well, like the bird cutouts here, because that is actually really nice on this page as well. So maybe I include something of that. And this is just a sheet. Oh, I should show my mother-in-law, because this is a sheet from my father-in-law that I die cut out. I could actually, if I do one of these, because we actually have those here. Or I just see a raven as well. We have big, oh, that's not, I think I have a raven in here. Yeah, these ones, the huge ones, but that's a scary one. But we have really big ravens here as well. So there's opportunities here. Opportunities here. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to take this page out. So it's going to be two sides that I'm going to work on. And yeah, Brooke, the boxes are so much fun to make. So honestly, really. And for this one to die cut, I use the base page from the planner. And I already here, I already put my, well, there's actually one Josette colored on this box. And then you see, I was thinking maybe this on there, but you know, possibilities. And then otherwise I have other pages. No, spruce tree do not change colors. Oh, do you call it tamarack? Do change colors? Isn't that Debbie? Isn't that the large as well? The large trees that change colors. Is that the same as tamarack? I thought it was large, but maybe I'm wrong. No, because it's called large valley, isn't it? Yeah, I think so. But for the box labels, oh, I use a label maker. So one of the label makers, one of those label printers, and then I have some paper behind it. I actually stamped the label from one of the sets from Esther. Oh, Maya. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Maya, you, Marjan, sorry. You really want the pizza box because they are so handy. Do you have the scarecrow in stock? Oh, Sir Stamp-a-Lot. I know Sir Stamp-a-Lot has, well, they ordered. So, and otherwise we ship pretty quickly. And for the UK, honestly, order through the stores because you don't want to get involved in weird transportation things. And to the stores, I'm knocking on my wood table here, or on my wood paper with a wood table underneath. It is actually going well so far. Okay, so I am going to color a few things. Do I see do I have a wood paper? what candy will fit in the pizza box? Hershey miniature. Yeah, oh, for sure. Yeah, Cindy. I have to I got, wait just a second. I know where I have something that I can show you. Because I got some from a guy that was promoting his political thing in the park here. So I have these here. They were still in my coat because otherwise the kids, you see, so these are caramel bars and those fit perfectly in here. So you can absolutely, I think you're, I think we're talking, Angelique, I think we're talking maybe Halloween treats here. Because here people go from door to door. So you can buy those huge bags with lots of treats in there. And I know the Ritter chocolate as a gift. But if you Did you say this? Yeah, for the flowers, for the Jessica, for the floral collection only, from Anita. And it is cards. Code is cards at checkout. Yeah. So if you buy those big bags, you can definitely, you can put about 3 of those bars in here, I would say. And I think for the parents, they are happy with the 3 bars and not more. Yeah, you know, I don't know. I will check because I actually will check with the paper because I don't know the weight from this paper anymore. So thank you. Sorry about that. But I will make a box from the from one of the papers from that we have ourselves, and then I kind of know what works. What works. I know, yeah, for trick or treat, this is cool. So I might do this in a little bit of a brownish color. I think that is nice for on this page. You see, kind of keep it in that tone. And so just my large, I know, Laura, yeah, for the, so you can do the candles, of course. You can do little gifts in it. You can do a gift card in it. I saw, who was it? Ingrid, I think. Posted, I think, I don't know if it's on the planner or on a family or the journal page, but Ingrid made a really, really nice gift for somebody from work. And she made, she put the insert in there from this one. And then you can decorate this, you can put a gift card in here. And she had that in the box, if I'm correct. You see? Yeah, that fits perfectly. So that is actually super cool. And then you can, so you see, and she decorated everything and it looked really, really nice. So this is a great way to give a gift card as well. And this is from the Into the Woods special. No. The Home Journal, the Home Jungle special. Sorry, Home Jungle, this one. And then you can put a gift card in here. You can make a note. I think she had a note for a gift or something. You can put it in here. So I think that is a great idea as well. And I'm pretty sure it was Ingrid that did that. Okay, so I know this was, yeah, that was a great idea. We have such a, we have a fantastic team, I have to say. And yeah, we have a great team. I can't say it out loud yet, but one of our team members is leaving. Not from the design team. Can't talk about it. No. No. I'll tell you, Anna found another great opportunity. So after lots of years for working for us, she is moving on to another job. But she's still with us for, I think, 2 weeks. But yeah. So that's, yeah, that's difficult. But of course for her a great, great opportunity which she needs to take. Okay, there we go. I know. So I'm doing that because that, and then I'm going to the sides. Might make great holders for special coins. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Then you need to watch like the watch the bottom if it's strong enough. I know, Belinda. I know. That is great for her. So I'm going to do this color, but I might. Yes, Sylvia, I just told the first, like, well, we've been waiting for ages. They're on a boat. We're even looking for creative other ways to package things to get things here by air again. But the watercolors, the last news was, the 5th of October, they changed to arriving in the harbor the 5th and then unloading the boat on the 8th and delivering the 11th. But honestly, I cannot. But yeah, it's just very unpredictable. Containers are very unpredictable. I know, Angelique. Anna is crying now on the other side. Anna. We didn't talk yet after that. Because we will both cry. Yeah. I have a tissue here, Anna. There we go. We are both very emotional persons. I think this is actually nice. So some watercoloring. So if I drop a tear, then it will just be a tear on my watercolor, which is good. Okay, I think this kind of resembles, I need to take, we have not been up to the large yet, because, I know, I know. It's good that I'm not in the view yet. If you want to go up to the large here, you need to be at Moraine Lake. That's a beautiful place to look at the large, but it is, you need to be there at 6 a.m. I told that earlier. And normally you can go up on Sunshine Village, like the ski hill, but that's not this year, so it's closed. Yeah, but Anna is young, eh? Anna is young, so she should pursue a career. And there we go. Oh my. So I think that is nice. So this is really kind of resembles the color nicely from how the trees look here. And this is what the large trees will, I know Ilse, yeah, I know Ilse, I did not tell you yet. It's very, very new news. There we go, a little bit more color here. And this tree is, I know what I'm doing right now, it's actually too big for the journal, but I'm going to do one more small one. Do I have enough? Let's see what I'm doing first. I'm going to also quickly color some pumpkins. That might be on the other side. Wipe my nose. You see, really, I'm a wussy. I am such a wussy. There we go. So I'm going to do that. Top pieces, that's all quick. Some pumpkins. Did you see the page, Ilse? Did you see this? So that's going in my journal. And you know, I was not allowed to show something, but but I know you passed it to yourself, Ilse, in some ways, but I'm not going to do your technique. But you also did something really, really cool with leaves as well. Okay, so do that. And I'm going to take, I think I'm going to take a little bit of orange and then, no, this one, and then go over it with some brown. So we kind of, oh, that's not the correct color. I need to do this one. And then go over it with some brown, kind of to tone it down a bit. What is it? Oh, Mercedes, I finally ordered a die cutter. So Mercedes, you had like a lot of dies already and no die cutting machine? That's, that's not, yeah. There we go. See, I touch it there, but it's fine because I'm going to add some. I'm going to do it a little bit lighter. Can I move the color to that side? Let's go like this. This one I touch, which is actually the I did buy 2 pumpkins already. So after this live, actually, in for the people in Canada, I do a live at, oh, I'm going to post it in between. Oh, I just did a video. Oh, I need to look it up. I will post it in the family group, because I will make a post. I did just a short video there. And then do a 2-hour live. I was going to travel to Edmonton, and then because of the new COVID rules, someone at the office, it's Anna that's leaving. Anna is Anna. Anna is working for us. Anna, how many years did you work for us? Or still working right now, but is it 6 years? I don't know exactly. 5 or 6 years for sure, or even longer, but yeah. I wanted to stay with the watercolor. So that's why I'm doing this, because I had Distress Ink watercolors. Or pumpkins, but I wanted to do I wanted to do watercolors. Oh, a little bit more brown, this one probably. Yeah, Anna's Anna, yeah, sorry, yeah. See, I wanted to add, probably go to. Yeah, so the watercolors are available in the US and Europe, and for, you know, so they're shipped all at the same time. You know, we have them for weeks already here, for weeks. And I know we are close, yes. And before I'm back, Anna's actually gone already, so but we're going to have dinner, we're going to meet when I'm back. And a little bit of orange. Yeah, of course, if you have the altar. So this one comes, these pumpkins come with the, this one comes with the card. See, I'm a little bit slow today. It's really Friday. I'm a little bit slow today. Just wipe it down a bit. Yeah, so Joep and Mark and Tom and Annika are up to Mount Norquay here with the lifts, and maybe they see some larger there. That could be. I told you to take pictures, so I hope you listened to me. Oh, oh, they are. Oh, good, Joep. Here you are. So you see, it worked out, Joep. So you are at Mount Norquay, Joep. So if you see large, Joep, can you take, please take pictures from the large trees over there, so the yellow ones. I would love to see that. And I know it's beautiful up there, I'm pretty sure. So that's that. And then I think I'm going to build a page already with the trees for now. Let's see what I'm going to do with that. And then those can dry. Oh yeah, that's also Femke, that's also nice, of course. You can do whatever you want. Oh, where's my page? Oh, here it is. Here it is. So I want to have these. I need maple leaves. I need all kinds of trees. Yes, me too. And yeah, the beautiful mushroom. You see, this page actually doesn't need anything more than this, I think, because I think that's beautiful. It might need a colored chipmunk, but I don't have those. No. Because chipmunks are everywhere. Always. So for this, I'm going to take a little piece of tape, a new die cutting so dice will involve another new acquisition on top. Oh, okay. Mercedes, I'm new to die cutting, so dice will. Mercedes, you're not the lady I saw in Calgary, Mercedes. Probably not, but that would be a coincidence. But I met a lady at Paper Pesta that was new to crafting. So I'm wondering if that's you, but it would be a very, very coincidence, yeah. Could you find me a bag of money, please? You know, the leaves are gold here, Belinda. So maybe if you fool some people, you can see that as real gold. And then try to exchange it. Yeah. Don't. Oh, no. Yeah. No. Exactly. So that's why I only do it here. Yeah. And I can still lift it up. I can still lift this up. And you see the tree is actually a perfect size. I need something at the bottom for sure. But I can easily lift this up again if I want to put something behind it. I can do that. I can send you a cutting of money tree. Yeah. Oh, thank you. Yeah. Yeah, so. And Mark is here for a few days and he's going back Sunday. So if the tape sticks out a little bit with this one, you just kind of, I did it without, you kind of just slide it because I don't want to have, I don't want to have tape sticking out here. Do I kind of blend them together a bit? Because I can kind of, you know, kind of weave them in a bit. I think that would be cool. Yeah, the background, I will do the background on Monday. Promise. Because I know I will have more leaves then. Oh, I need to slide it up a little bit. Otherwise, it's going to be on the fold of the... So it's kind of nice to kind of just blend them into each other. So I think that's cool. But now I definitely need something here. What am I going to put on the ground there? I should put some real needles there. But I also think I can do... I had the mushroom core because that's too big for there. I think this is just pretty as it is. Because if you see that, like, because that's going to be here. You see, that's going to be here. I think that just blends beautiful. And I might even do a picture here. Or I might do a little tree here as well. That I make another tree. I should do that. Going to make so this blends together, and then I absolutely should do another. So I'm going to color something. I feel the need to a chipmunk, because I know Ilse. So I stopped. I don't know if you got that part, but the large trees here are actually coloring, but then they lose their needles. But and the brush. This brush is a size 6. I also like the more, I also have, there's also a 6. Well, that looks totally different. Oh, this is a 9. It's a really old brush from Bruinzeel. But, so you can also do it with that one. But, I want to do one more tree. I'm painting 3 trees in this life. But I will have something done at the end. For sure. And then, that, and then this color. I know, it's going to be nice. But you know, when I see stuff like this, I also think, frame, like a frame with the scenery, because with all the new fall things we have, and then the Into the Woods collection, it's something Ilse could do. Because Ilse makes really nice, like really art pieces as well. And, I know she can do like a real scenery in a frame or something. Easily will be pretty as well. I have not been to IKEA here yet, so I think I need to have an IKEA run here. Maybe tomorrow when we drop off Mark. Maybe we can do that. And of course, so these are from the mason jar. Let's take a little bit of ink away here. So it's a little, yeah, okay, that's that. And then I can already put my pumpkins together. I'm going to do, yeah, the trees are from the, that's a mesa, from the mesa. And I did, but they actually fit really nice in the, that's what I mean. All the designers work so well together, but this is kind of probably a coincidence again, but a good one. Let's go in here. I might need to make these a little bit darker, but I can do that later as well. So using just a little bit of the Kids' Choice glue here. That was not, oh, okay. Oh, Pennsylvania, that's different. Okay, that is totally different. But I thought, well, maybe it was you, because I know that lady started stamping. If Carol is here, she probably would know her name, but she did not die cut yet, I think. Oh, yes, she did. She did die cut. I know she did, because she had dies. But she was really a beginner. It's amazing that I didn't lose any pieces. Hi, Petra, as well. So, lots of people here again. So, again, if you want to make a chance for the Spotlight $100 gift certificate, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And also comment on the video. And the video you want to comment on is the 2021 Fall and Halloween release from Planner Essentials and Josette van der Burgt. When you get a new collection of paper, do you automatically cut out some different pages? Jeanette, it depends. I do. That's actually what I do a lot. Because I'm not a systematic worker as some people are. So there are people that, like Esther, for instance, she die cut a page and then works on it because she does one every week. A spread in her journal, in her planner. For the journal, I kind of cut pages. So here I cut pages. So that's from the paper, Wanderlust paper. So I do that. I have some, I just showed my mother-in-law actually, because this is from covers from old plakboeken. I don't know, things that my father-in-law had. So I have that in there. And I have the fabric in here. You see the waxed fabric in here. So I do that. Yeah. You know, if you go on a hayride, you need to go snipe hunting. I have no idea. I'm going to design one of the elusive snipes. I don't even know what a snipe is. Okay, Angelique, can you Google snipes, what it is? Anybody that's in the Netherlands. Snipe, what snipe is? What snipe is? I have no idea. Yeah. No, I like to work like that, because then at the end it will just be a bulky journal, and I just like that. And I have the same with our planners. That's just, but hi Kenneth, I like that because it's you know, it's just how I work. Yeah, no one else knows what a snipe is. I have no idea. A snipe, I need to Google it. So if anybody's there that can Google what a snipe is. So this one I need to make a little bit like color a little bit more with distress or something. Look, someone is with. It's mud. It's mud. Oh, it's like looking for some. Oh, okay. It's looking for something. A snipe. No, it's no. It was a different word. But it's okay. Not nicer. I just. Okay. I need to. There is a Whittersnip yacht. Okay. Made up joke to play on kids. Okay. I will Google it after the live and see what it is. It's a game, probably. It's a game, and you at the end, you don't find anything. We got something going here. It's a game in the, so basically you hunt something that's not there. Is that what you understand? Oh, wait, is that fitting on there? Oh, it is. Is that what I understand? Snipe is a bird. Yeah, it's a bird. Okay. Water snip. Yeah, that's definitely not that. Water snip has nothing to do with Halloween. So I would be surprised. Sniper is a sharp shooter, but I don't think that's what you mean. No sniper. No. That would be not very good for the hill. Yeah. Okay. We'll figure it out. It's a. Okay, there we go. Oh, that's see, that's the wanderlust paper that you see here. It's a wild goose chase that doesn't exist. Okay, that's what it is. So you kind of tell the kids in the maze, probably then, to find something. And a maze is a doolhof for the Dutch people. So they made a corn maze, kind of in the cornfields. They make a doolhof. And so you chase something that's not there. You just go from one, yeah, okay. Okay, that is it. And making noise, it might pretend to find something making noise. Yeah, so even if you, so they make noise and you think something is there, you hunt it, and then that's not. Yeah, okay. I think that's probably what it is. Now, I do want something at the bottom here. So I'm going to go for 1 second because I want to have a little bit of my box with my tea bags and that kind of stuff. 1 second. Be right back again. I'm actually pretty well organized here. Oh, that's fabric and then I need paper. Because I have my big boxes here with my papers and my, because that's too flat there. So I might just, you see, because the tea bag collar will be really nice there. Or my cheese linen, but then I feel that is, or burlap, or you see that's, I'll just skip this here. And I also have my orange kind of cheese cloth here. I'm just going to open this, see what I'm going to use. And then it's almost, you see, I don't do a lot, but it's cool. Home Jungle is coming back. Ooh, is it sold out in the Netherlands? I think it's available in the US still. But I don't know for sure. But that's, if it's gone, it's gone. If it's gone, it's gone. Yeah. So I might do something here, or here, or this, or different, of course. No, I think this color is pretty nice here. Let me see what I want to do. Oh, that's what we used to do with newbies in the office. Let them find a file with lost papers. Oh, Angelique. And then they still stayed. Or did they leave the company right away again? Yeah. And you don't have files that you want to lose, Angelique. Well, you know, your customers would like you to lose them. Angelique is in Deurwaarder. I don't know how that's called here. But is that correct, Angelique? I think it's called still Deurwaarder, or maybe it's a different name. I don't know. But so, you know, if she would have had a file on me, I would not mind if she's losing it. So... in this case, I would not have trouble with you losing my file. Okay, I'm just going to add a little bit of glue here. Process server. Okay. Process server. Okay, so a little bit there. And then I might add some. Of course, I officially need my stapler now, but I'm not going to walk away again. Because I need to staple. I want to staple that, but I do that later. Messenger at arms, that sounds very enforcement officer. That's Angelique, we should not have said that because now people don't like me anymore. No, that's not true. So I think that's nice because it goes with the collar there, and I do a little piece there. Hello, Joseph. Where were you, Joseph? You are late, checking in late, Joseph. Lunchtime. Is it lunchtime for you? That. And then I honestly think we need to do a... let me see how it goes. Because the pumpkins I will save for the other side. And I want to tone them down a little bit more. Because on the other side of this, I wanted to do the... so this is cool. And this I need to glue. So I think that will be nice. And then I do have some little fall leaves that I, or am I just going to add a big fall leaf? Let me see. What do I have here? In this collection, we have the small fall leaves. No, that's too much orange now. And this, I want to do that one on the other side, so not here. No, it really needs a colored image from the, or the bird in here, but I think it needs a colored image from the, it's actually cool as well. Now from the, I want to have the chipmunk in there. Do I have a tiny bird that I can put in the tree? Oh, I do have a large bird, but that's too large. The owl was actually pretty nice because we have, and this is too big, but we definitely have those here, like the falcons and the, but I am, now I'm going to color, let me color, because I think I have that, let me see, into the woods. I still need to finish this one with an image on the front. Let me see if I have another, oh, I do have another chipmunk. That needs to go there. And this one, I want to make a page here with this and the pumpkins, and but that will be later then. You see, that side. Gerichtsvollwei. Oh my goodies. International. It's everywhere. Maybe I add a little bit of this here as well. Just on the fabric. I think that's actually cool. Yeah, so the turkey is going on the other side, yeah. I know, Nancy, and this is, that's what I, so this, my journal will really be just fall, because I have some really, really nice fall pictures from here. So that, you see, kind of tone that orange down a bit, and I might do the same on this side. And then I will call it a chipmunk, and put it there. There we go. Oh, I have some really nice rusty color, kind of a rusty color here. Take that. There we go. Yeah, the Rudy the Kalkoen is going on the other side. So this is really going to be like the four, like the large trees here. And then so I'm just going to stick that here. And then here I can do a picture. If you have a nice picture in the with the large trees today, I can put it there. But I have some really nice fall pic because honestly, it is really pretty here. And then you see here I have the deer already here. That's from the new collection Into the Woods. So I'm going to color this one and then cut it out. And that's going to go peeking in there. So then I want to go a little bit darker with the chipmunk, I think, in this case. Kind of that it stands out a little bit more, although it's, of course, it's, there needs to be kind of a little bit of a red. You see, that's probably too dark, but I'll see. Now, and then I should do a little, maybe I'll take some of the more lighter color in here, you see? Just in here a bit, because that's more like the, so I have a little bit of a more darker, there we go. So this is from the Into the Woods collection. And then, I don't know, but I'm gonna recover. I'm working full time. Oh, still from your broken foot. Was your foot correct, Angelique? Oh, really? Is it still from there, Angelique? Yeah, because you need to walk and drive, of course. That is difficult. Are you still recovering from that? Yeah. It definitely took longer. Your ankle. Oh. Yeah, you don't want to break things. And some things just recover faster than the other. He is so cute. I'm going to add a little bit of this color in there as well. Oh, too dark. Kind of mix in a little bit of the red color. because just a tiny bit here as well. And then the body, I'm like the this is so relaxing to do. And then so you make these and then you put them in your pizza box. Yeah, too much. Yeah, I can imagine. How time are we? Oh yeah, I can make this. So this is going to be colored as well. This, the feet, and that's going to be light, and that's going to be light. Too much paint. Over here, I can go and set the line a bit, that's fine. And then some of this color. Heb ook het huisje een boompje. Ja, I know. That is so relaxing. And my mom said that is a TV exists so many years or something. And and then you just, you know, there was some kind of old programs or whatever, so you can kind of see that a little bit. And also I watched chansons here in the like yesterday. That's a super, and that's, I think that's again tonight or tomorrow. And it's also one of those programs that you just put on, or the, like in the Netherlands, De Beste Zanger. De Beste Zanger, I like that program. But it's something you don't need to watch the whole time, and then you can just color. That is so nice. Just going to be a little bit more kind of like that. So now I have a darker and a little bit of that. Then I'm going to do a tiny bit of color here. And then I really want a super light color. We're going to even do that over there. Because it's not white, so like a super light color. And then go to dab that, that it just has a little bit of color. Same here. And same here. And I'm just going to dab that. I need to spread that a bit more. And that, I can just take it off with my brush as well. See, so it has a little bit of color that I'm going to in the ear as well. It's that. Then I'm going to give him a black nose. You can color that as well. I'm just going to make it black. And I see I did not stamp the... This watercolor paper I have is too heavy, has too much structure for these lines. So it didn't stamp completely black, so doing that. And then I'm going to give him a little thing of white here. Like a little... Let's get it started. Here we go. Some white, and I might add a little tip of white here with the gel pen. Kind of make this a little bit more standing out. I think now I'm going to cut it out and then see how it looks. So again, this watercolor paper is perfect. This is much heavier, and I know I showed it in earlier. So this is nice, that's heavy for die cutting. And it rounds it off really nice. So for this, it's really nice to do the heavy. But for stamping, I like it a little bit lighter. And I'm going to try to cut it close to the edge. So you can also leave a little white line if you want to. But that's up to you. I don't need to see it well. Cutting in like that, that's not nice else. Okay, so what are the plans for the weekends? What are the plans for the weekends? Angelique is coloring, I saw. So do we have time to play? I know in the Netherlands my mom said it was colder. But here it's beautiful, beautiful fall weather. I have to say, it's really nice. I know, Marianne, isn't it great? I love the chipmunk as well. Or the squirrel, sorry. Squirrel. And I should, let me see. It's a vine, but I don't know what kind of winged. Oh, yeah, okay. Oh, the winged. Oh, that is really nice to, yeah, I had those that one in the Netherlands. That is like really, really, really red. That is really pretty. Yeah. Yeah, Marga, I hope so with you. Marga, I hope your mother is doing okay. Marga has, her mother was not doing that well, so. I know Marga has been running back and forward to her mom visiting. Which we are lucky then, Marga, that we can do it this time again. I'm pretty sure you are happy with that as well. Oh, okay, it's cold and wet here. Nice to redoing your crap. I'm Angelique, you're always redoing. Send them going to the zoo, Blijdorp. Oh, that is nice. That is nice. Blijdorp, it's been years since I've been there, but I know my family goes there on a regular basis. And I know it's super cool. There is a at the children's farm here, like a petting zoo here. There's a kinderboerderij. They have the pumpkins, but that will be so busy this weekend. That is not fun to go there. Way too many people. But it would make great because all the buildings at that petting zoo is are red. And then with the orange pumpkins. But it's too much. Probably too much. Too busy. Too busy. Okay, that's it. Got it done. And then normally what I do, I go around with my black pen, but I don't have that at hand. But I think I did a great job with cutting, so that's fine. Oh, that will finish it. That is fun. Fixing the second drawers. Oh, okay. We're talking IKEA here. Yeah. There we go. Oh, something is driving backwards here. You hear that? You hear the noise? And, okay, I know something that I want to do.
1 second.
1 second. So, my son-in-law, Tom, they made something that's huge. Like, it's actually super fun. Plastic cup. Get the bottom out. Ilse, if you're still here, it will be really nice for your sons. Plastic cup. You take out the bottom. And then you cut open a balloon. And you tie it at where the knot is. And then I have it here as well. I'm going to show you because that was so much fun. I think I have it here. That is the big advantage of a very tiny place. But if you have kids, this is super fun. So that water cups, so small water cups. So you take a balloon, super fun for kids to make. Take a balloon, cut it open, and then there's a knot here. And then you want it, of course, try to if it works, if it shoots something. We were at school, so what was outside were pine cones. And those are light, these are light, those are small ones. So instead of, so you can do this in here. And then I'm going to shoot the pine cone. Pew! Almost out of the window. How cool is that? So if you have small kids, plastic cup, balloon, super fun thing to do. Super fun thing. And the pine cones, they are so small that they will not hurt anybody. But well, you know, you always need to watch. Of course, you don't want to cut to. You don't want to shoot people. To people, but it's really fun. So, but these are really tiny pine cones. I know, it's really fun. So, and I know, oh, this is actually, oh, here we go. Am I over time? I am over time, and I need to do another live, but if I just take this, this needs to go on the floor, because that's what chipmunks do. They actually break all these, and I can, there we go. That's it. I'm going to put those on the floor here, on the ground. Because they're always under the tree. Because they take their... I know, just don't shoot at people, so for sure. But this is super soft, so... but don't shoot at people. Absolutely. And that's what we tell them, of course. But, you know, if you hide behind trees or whatever, it's kind of a fun thing to play in the forest. So we did the, so in this case I'm going to give him, so again I did it with the, but I'm going to cut this open and then give him a piece of that in his hands. Thank you, Jen. I had fun. I hope you did as well. I'm just going to finish this quickly because I think it will be fun if I give him a real piece of a pine cone in his hands. So fold this open, put this in here, slide it in here. Oh, it breaks. But here we go. So he has a real piece of pine cone. I just need to put some glue here as well. Whoops. Because that's what chipmunks do here. They go in the tree, take the pine cones, and then I'm going to add a little bit of glue here. And then I'm going to put a few of those here. And these are super flat. And if they break a little bit, that's fine, of course. Oh, that's where I think I'm going to put my chipmunk there. So that one here. So that will dry. And then I'm going to take my little chipmunk. Put some glue on that in the back as well. So just like that. And then put him here. Just here. Under the tree, because that's where the pine cone pieces are. How fun is that? Well, I think that's fun. And it has a darker brown color. There we go. That's it. Thank you, Sylvia. I sure had fun, so let it put it in the TN. And I sure had fun creating this. And you see with the chipmunk, there's just a little piece of glue, a little bit of glue on his body. And that's fine, of course, because then the it's kind of looks more natural. So this one goes here. And I'll work on the other one next week somewhere. Goes here, this can go under. And then this one goes here. Yeah, so now we all know what we're going to do this weekend. We're going to find pine cones. We're going to find nice leaves. And on Monday, I'll show you how I did that page. Ah, this makes me happy. I think it looks fun. Yeah, cool, cool, cool. You see? I am in love. Okay, so again, the notes. Thank you all for the hearts. Thank you. So that is the best compliment that you can give me, that you want to recreate this. Thank you for that. I love that. Spotlight of the week, 2021 Fall and Halloween release from the Planner Essentials and Yozette. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and comment on the release video for a chance to win a $100 gift certificate to our online store. It ends October the 5th and the winner will be announced the 6th and also in the description box below the video. And then the special for this weekend is the like a floral collection from Anita, 20% discount ends Sunday night. And the code is CARDS. And it is because it's World Card Making Day tomorrow, actually. And that is on that collection. And the pizza box is in that collection. So all have a wonderful, wonderful weekend. Thank you for watching. And I will see you again on Monday. Bye-bye.